Hare Krishna. To regulate your eating, listen to your body, not to your mind. For all of us, we have certain needs which have to be taken care of. But at the same time, see, there is the body, we as conscious beings are the soul, and in between there is the mind. So when the body gives us some signals, say for example, we are tired, we need to sleep, we are hungry, we need to eat. The body gives us some signals. And the body's signals are what we as conscious beings need to hear. And the mind needs to be like a medium, like a reflector which shows whatever the signal the body is giving. But instead of being a window to the body, the mind can become like a distorter. It can become, it can start showing us something else entirely. So many times when we feel hungry, are we actually hungry? Means, is it the body that needs food, or is it the mind that is craving for food? How do we know that? If the mind is craving for food, that is pseudo hunger. When the body needs food, it is hunger. And the key difference between the two is in terms of what is healthy and what is unhealthy. When the body is hungry, it generally eats the food, that is, it is not particularly selective. So selectiveness and untimeliness, these two characterize the voice of the mind. That how do we know, I say, I want this and this and this only. And especially if that is not a healthy food, a general rule of dietetics could be that if it tastes good, it is bad for you. Of course, it's not always true. There can be food which can taste good and which can be healthy for us. But if you're selecting food solely based on taste alone and not health, and that is the kind of food we are craving for, which we know is unhealthy, then that is the voice of the mind. And untimeliness. That means we have eaten enough food, now we have lived in our body for many years, and we know the overall pattern of our body, when it feels hungry and when it doesn't. So if we don't recognize, if we feel an urge that is untimely, then that hunger is usually coming from the mind, not the body. And the Bhagavad-Gita urges us to regulate by staying connected. Yuktahara viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta swapnava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkaha. The 6th chapter says that by being regulated in our eating, sleeping, we can actually practice yoga and attain freedom from distress. Now yukta can mean regulated, yukta can also mean connected. So when we are connected with what? Connect with our own spirituality, connected with the supreme spiritual reality, Krishna, then that connection brings clarity. So when we feel hungry, maybe we can plan, let me take a few deep breaths, let me chant a few mantras, let me pray to Krishna, remember Krishna, and let me by that clean the mind. Okay, after, so we feel hungry, instead of just grabbing food, we wait to calm the mind by deep breathing, by chanting, by reverse recitation. And then with the calm mind, we try to look within. Then we can see whether the urge, based on its selectiveness and untimeliness also, we can check whether the urge is coming from the body or the mind. And when it is coming from the body, then we will cater to it appropriately. If it's coming from the mind, we don't have to pander to it. Thank you. Hare Krishna.